Did you know you can record high-quality video with multiple remote guests all from your iPad? With the Riverside app, your iPad becomes a complete production studio where you can have multiple participants and producers record multi-track high-quality audio and video. Plus, your guests can tune in from their iPhone, iPad, their computer, or Android device. So here's how you get started. Open the App Store on your device and search for the Riverside app. When you see our wave icon, download our app for free. If you already have a Riverside account, you can hit the sign in button. If not, you can sign up and create a new free Riverside account. Now, once you sign in, if you already have a Riverside account, you'll see the previous studios that you may have used to record other shows. If you're new to Riverside, you can create a new studio by tapping Create New. As you create your studio, you can think of it as the place you keep returning to record that one show. So maybe it's your show name or maybe your business name, but you can name your studio whatever you'd like. We'll call it Riverside Mobile for now. Now you can choose to record audio only in this studio or video. Then tap Create. Once you've created your studio, you can now tap into that studio. Next, you'll enter the name that will appear to you and your other participants in the call. You can add a photo if you'd like. And once you put your name, hit Next. Now before you jump into the live studio, you have a chance to preview your camera and check any microphone and headphone settings. You definitely want to use a pair of headphones, otherwise the voice of your other participants will be heard in your microphone. You can turn on echo cancellation in Riverside, but you'll get a better quality recording if everyone's wearing headphones. Now, when it comes to the camera on your iPad, iPads don't have the ability to use external webcams or mirrorless cameras in the device, so you have to use the built-in camera on your iPad. Now, cameras on iPads can vary in quality depending on the age of your device. Just make sure you're in a well-lit room so your iPad doesn't have to boost those low-light levels, because that's when it gets noisy or grainy video and you won't have the best quality possible. Now, one feature you might see on some iPads is called center stage. Modern iPads use center stage, which can actually follow you around the room as you move. We would actually recommend leaving center stage off, because what it's actually doing is zooming in on the video and you're losing pixels or losing quality of your video because it's zooming in as you record. So this symbol right here for center stage, which is right before you actually join the live studio, we recommend turning that off. This is what it looks like with center stage turned off. The camera stays in one place, it's a static shot, but if you turn center stage on, you'll see it'll start zooming in on my face and it will actually try to follow me as I move around the room. Again, it can be unpredictable and you're losing quality because it's zoomed in. So make sure that that's unchecked to get the best quality video possible. So for the best quality audio, we recommend using a USB microphone. I'm going to connect this USB microphone to the iPad Pro, and you'll actually be able to see and hear what it sounds like when I record with Riverside on my iPad. If you have your USB microphone, as long as it has a USB-C on the other side, some iPads still have a Lightning connector, but you can just connect your USB microphone directly to your iPad, and Riverside will use that microphone in your recording. Now, when you plug in a USB microphone, you're going to get this warning. If your USB microphone has a headphone jack built in, you can connect your headphones to your USB microphone and both hear and speak at the same time with no issue during your Riverside recording. But if your USB microphone does not have a headphone jack, you'll have to toggle between speaking and hearing throughout the call. This is a limitation of the iPad software itself, not the Riverside app. So you will have to go between talking and listening in your recording. But if your USB microphone has a built-in headphone jack and you can plug in those wired headphones, tap No, and then you'll be able to both hear and speak at the same time without toggling during the recording. Now, you can invite guests, producers, or you can invite audience members who just view but actually don't participate in the call. Producers can have background tasks and actually produce the show, but they won't be recorded. You can learn more about producers in the video above. But if you want to invite other participants, those that you will record actually on the call, maybe it's your podcast co-host or a special guest, then you want to send a guest invite. When you hit Send Guest Invite, you can either copy a link or hit the More button, and you'll see the typical share sheet where you can then send the link via text, email, or various other ways. Now, once all the participants are on their call and you're ready to record, you as the host can hit the Record button, and you'll see the recording gives you the countdown, and it will begin recording all the participants on separate video tracks and audio tracks. You'll get separate recordings for each participant. To give you a little preview of what the iPad camera quality will look like, this is the 2021 M1 iPad Pro, and I'm recording it with the built-in front-facing camera. Center stage is turned off, and I'm using a USB microphone. So again, you can get pretty great sounding audio, and if you have proper lighting, not in a dim area, and you can be in a quiet environment, you can get a great quality recording. As with all your Riverside calls, you'll see an upload monitor there in the top right corner of your screen. you can see that Riverside is uploading your audio and video as the call progresses. So even if someone drops out, you still get access to the amount of recording that's been uploaded. And you could even invite a producer to join you in the recording. And if they're on a computer, they can access things like the chat room, allow guests in from the waiting room, and other things that you might not be able to do in the iPad app. Those things the producer can handle while they're on the call. When you're ready to end the recording, you can hit the stop. You'll get a confirmation that the recording has been saved. And you can tell your participants, try to wait to keep the web browser open until you see 100% upload progress. And then those recordings are available to you in the cloud. You can log into your Riverside account on a computer and download all those tracks separately, both separate video tracks and audio tracks from each participant. Once you're back at your computer, you can log into your Riverside account and then go to the studio you use to record. Here it's Riverside Mobile. I'll click View All Recordings, and there's the call. I was all three participants. And when you click that, you can scroll down and view all the separate tracks. You can download both video and audio tracks for every participant. And you'll see here the three recordings, two iPads, one computer, all together, and you can download those files and then edit them. Or you can hit the Edit and Export button here in the studio, and you can actually export a full-length recording with all the participants already laid out in a three-up frame. Or you can even use the Magic Editor to highlight the active speaker throughout the call. So that's how you can use the iPad as a complete production studio. Host a podcast or other video recording, get high-quality separate tracks for all your participants, and you did it all from an iPad. You can also create high-quality video content using the Riverside iPhone or Android app. You can click the link above to learn more about our iPhone app, or if you would just like to learn about the entire Riverside platform as a whole, you can click that video and learn how to get started creating high-quality video content using Riverside. If you learned something new, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel for more content about podcasting, how to create high-quality video content, equipment, and more. Plus, drop a comment below this video and let us know what you create with Riverside. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll catch you next time.